Kishka brought you here to help proffer tribute challenges, little brother, not sit around mew. Forgive this one's baby brother. He was weeping about... Wait, what was he? Never mind. Welcome to the club. This one assumes you seek new challenges and amazing rewards. This is true, yeah? Yes, and what fragrant challenges they are. Each day, Kishka creates new tasks for rank and renown. One will pit you against the common folk of Tamriel. The other will set you against card-playing adventurers like yourself. I offer only two challenges per day, but you can earn sweeter prizes by winning multiple matches. Small rewards for a single win, fine prizes for two, and a grand bounty for three. Kishka will also make sure your rank soars if you participate. Ha! You would fill your purse with heaps of tiny baubles? No, Walker. As this one said, you can win one match for a tiny reward, or keep playing for a bigger prize. Simple, yes? The more you play, the sweeter the reward. It is Kishka's pleasure. Come back soon, yes? This one's grand challenges will be waiting. Now, you should go find Bragas. He is out on the seaside patio, most likely. Kishka is very busy doing... something. What was Kishka doing again? This one.
Ah, there's my new favorite roister. I guess if you've spoken to Sorin and Kishka and gotten their sage advice, it's down to me to provide the final part of the chapter's introductions and provide one last little acorn of wisdom. We should have a word about Dex, I guess. Those Dex Razumar gave you are just the beginning. Fresh Dex pop up all over Tamriel, and each of them offers a unique style of play. You can even find upgrades to the cards you already own. I've earned a fair amount from just playing tribute. Kishka offers them in her daily challenges sometimes, especially if you hit those win streaks. I've even heard rumors that adventurers find them out in the wild. Well, between you, me, and old Bendu there, I've heard they might offer some new decks as prizes in the upcoming tournaments. Beyond that, it's a mystery. Just keep working on raising that rank by playing matches. That's the best path to success. Well, if not, you're close. Go talk to Razumad and let him know you introduce yourself to the chapter's premier players. He'll be glad to hear it.
Welcome back! You return wiser and hungrier for competition, is it not so? Tribute has that effect on people. Now, I have something for you. A gift and formal welcome to the Gonfalon chapter of the Roysters Club. I know you will put it to good use. Just a little something from the chapter's strongbox. Now then, you have Dex. You are versed in the rules and familiar with your fellow competitors. Truly, you have all you need to step into formal play. We proudly welcome you to our I have it on good authority that preparations for the Roysters Club tournaments are well underway. Continue to refine your strategies, collect new cards, and increase your rank. If you work hard, I'm certain you'll be ready when the time comes.
Welcome, Walker. You have come seeking this one's fragrant daily challenge, yes? Kishka has one to offer, she thinks. This one has a list of rival chapters, each with a host of worthy players. Beat players in all three locales, and you will win a grand prize. But even a single victory will earn you a reward. You are prepared, yes? Bandar favor you. Remember, you represent the Gonfalon chapter now. That means... Well, Kishka does not know what that means. Just play well, yes?
What? You want to face me in a tribute match?
Thank you. sings a song. He'll sing it.
Some people don't like the bustle of cities, but I come from a big family, so it reminds me of home.
I have something to talk to you about.
I'm afraid you need a few more notches in your belt before you can face me. Raise your rank?
think you can...
Thank you.
Remember, you represent the Gonfalon chapter now. Very well. This is a simple reward, true, but today's challenges are ready, Walker.
find his keepers, as they say.
Siren episode, the Pacific Dissipity. The way I say the words, dude, let's go!
You're a sight for sore eyes. I've been looking for someone to help with a problem, but I wasn't expecting you to come by. My patron needs someone like you. Competent and unknown here on High Isle. I promise it'll be worth your while. Lady Arabelle DeVoe. Maybe you've heard of her. She's a famous investigator and author. Diplomat, too. Which is why she's here. She runs in circles way above my station.
earth, you swit! Watching.
Take me!
No worries. I've got you. I think. You there! Burn the webs! Quickly! Quickly! Mephala's damn webbing. It's in all my nooks and crannies. Thanks for helping, though.
No! Save the Dawnstar gem!
The spider poison, it's spreading fast. Take this, Resolute Diamond. Don't let the Golden Knight sacrifice be in vain. Then you know we're Tower Sentinels, guardians of the diamond keys that open the Crystal Tower. Please, make sure my diamond remains safe. Mephala, Prince of the Secret Arts, she sought my diamond. but also seemed very interested in the Golden Knight. I fear she's taken him to the Spiral Skein. remain safe. The spider, then you know. Mephala, prince of the secret arts. She sought my diamond, but also seemed very interested in the Golden Knight. Tell Anaya, I'm sorry.
Ah, there you are. The Rightmaster needs you back in Arteum immediately. Find him in Kagura Tower as soon as you can.
Betel Reeve Tanalina requests your presence at the Royal Palace. There is a situation developing. There are eager ears everywhere, so keep your voice low. The situation involves Sea Sloat. The Betel Reeve has been informed that you dispatched one of the foul creatures. I find that implausible, but as a lowly I can tell you that the Betel Reeve sent three adventurers and a squad of marines to determine the extent of the problem. After an initial report, contact with the group was lost. What the Battle Reeve will ask of you, well, that's for her to impart.
Vault of Moawita, but it shouldn't be empty. Something's very wrong.
Oh, there you are. The Relic Master has been looking all over for you. You know, I didn't think to ask. Maybe it has to do with the missing relics. Yes, that sounds about right. Well, yes, but the Relic Master didn't seem too upset by the whole ordeal. He probably already saw how we were going to get them back. Maybe you have something to do with that? Just go ahead into the college ruins over there. You can't miss him.
Ulysseta, do you have a moment? A friend of mine, she's Ulysseta Gracog. We're not friends exactly. More like colleagues. Well, perhaps we are friends. I'm not sure. She doesn't make it easy. Anyway, none of that matters. What matters is that she's put herself in harm's way again. Please don't tell anyone, but I think she stole a seeing stone called the Eye of Remembrance and took it to Traitor's Vaults. I told her to put it back. The Relic Master will be furious. I thought she'd seen reason, but when she missed breakfast...
Thank you for returning so promptly. Before we get to other matters, tell me about your search for the Tower Sentinels. Valcerin recounted the events at the College of Sapiox after she returned with Lathan. But I'm eager to hear your report. Mephala, curse her name! Along with her cohorts, Clavicus Vile and Nocturnal, she corrupted Lathan and threatens all of Nirn. But the Sapiox no longer have an attuned pair of keybearers. That will make it harder to access the Crystal Tower. That Golden Knight is one of Meridia's champions, I believe. It seems that one Daedric Prince is trying to help us. That gem is the Dawn Star, from the Dawnbreaker Sword. Why take the Knight prisoner, though? What are the Princes playing at here? Meridia is the Daedric Prince of Life and Light, and the Matron of the Colored Rooms. She isn't part of the Triad of Princes. Indeed, it seems that she has specifically sent her champion to oppose them. We'll need to keep that in mind as we proceed. Hmm? Oh, Yes. Without two attuned tower sentinels, the Sapiarchs can't use the diamond keys to open the way to the Crystal Tower. The attuning process usually takes a year and a day, and I have no idea if they can hasten the process. It involves my missing memories. I've recalled an important detail, and I need to show it to you. For now, let me compensate you for your efforts so far. I appreciate your help in all this. While you were gone, I have been scrying through my own memories, trying to find the missing events that will remind me where I hid the Heart of Transparent Law. I believe I have discovered something significant. Not exactly. While scrying through my memories, I saw half-formed thoughts and splintered recollections. I saw myself enter the Dreaming Cave beneath Kapora Tower, and I held the Heart of Transparent Law in my hands. I opened a portal, but I can't recall where it went. Something intentionally blocked the destination from my sight. I entered the portal, and time passed. Then I was back in the cave, and the heart was gone. Will you accompany me to the Dreaming Cave? The answer to where I hid the Heart of Transparent Law resides in the Dreaming Cave. Or, more precisely, through the portal I opened and once traversed. But therein lies the problem. It's best if I showed you. Meet me in the cave beneath this tower. Welcome to the Dreaming Cave. Here, we can open paths to other realms. This particular path is blocked by Daedric magic. I have an idea, though. Take the Dawnstar gem from your pack and hold it up to the barrier. Just as I surmised, the barrier, it withdraws from the Dawnstar's power. Dawnbreaker's gem contains a portion of Meridia's power, but on its own it isn't strong enough to dispel this barrier. We need to find the Dawnbreaker's sword and make it whole once more. We know that at least one Daedric Prince has attempted to help us against the triad of Vile, Mephala, and Nocturnal. I think it's time to approach Meridia and solicit her help in this endeavor. We need to locate a true believer, one of Meridia's cultists. If anyone can direct us toward Daedric activity on Somerset, it's Lathan. Talk to Lathan. See if you can convince him to help us find one of Meridia's priests.
Let's ride! Never have enough of that.
Of this place, Vault of Moawita, but it shouldn't be empty. Something's very wrong.
I never planned to come back here. The memories are painful.
I still can't believe I had to find you and drag you back. Was our time together really so terrible?
You still don't understand. Our daughter will never again see this view, or hold my hand, or anything. I suppose it's too much for a prisoner to expect a few moments of solitude with his thoughts. Ah, well. So, what can I do for you? Has the Right Master sent you to interrogate me? Doesn't he trust my wife's talents in that regard? What a curious question. Do you actually believe that all Daedric cultists know each other? I hate to disappoint you, we don't. Although I can tell you that there are a lot fewer of the Lady of Life's followers now than there were before. The Court of Bedlam has been actively eliminating the competition, as it were. Oh, I wasn't personally involved. But I have it on good authority that the Meridia Shrine, hidden to the north of Shimmerine, has been disposed of. All? Who can say? I imagine that one or two of them scurried down a dark hole before the blade fell. Like rats, her followers are. I believe I have said everything I'm going to on this subject. Now shove off.
That sounds like a wild Nyxad chase. Didn't Razumdar mention he was investigating Daedric cults on Somerset? Maybe you should go talk to him. Razumdar has been investigating Daedric activity across Somerset. He's your best chance for finding a follower of Meridia, despite what Lathan has intimated. When last we checked, the Eye of the Queen was in Shimmerine, conducting his own investigation into the Court of Bedlam and other Daedric activity. If anyone in Somerset can point you to a priest of Meridia, it's Razumdar.
Thank you. If the Queen's Eye wants to chase his own tail by following Skeeva scribblings, fine by me. Anything to keep him out of our business.
Step away from that scribble, newcomer.
Take a breath, bailiff. It's just a scribble, not one of Razendar's conspiracies.
Only one of the lesser races would deface a beautiful wall like that. I mean no disrespect, but my statement rings true. Razendar claims the scribble contains a message of some sort, but I just don't see it. The cat mentioned he was working with a newcomer. But if you ask me about Daedra, I'll toss you down a pit. As I told Razendar, Somerset banished Daedric cults centuries ago. Our biggest problem right now concerns these wall scribblers. Do I look like a Khajiit keeper to you? He said something about the scribbles. I'm just glad Razendar is far away and not bothering me. You, on the...
What is it?
Raz doesn't care who you worship. He just wants to know if your cult was attacked recently.
Perry, I would welcome you. Our prince accepts all kinds, and you'd be our first Khajiit.
You'd be our first anything, actually.
Five Claw, you have the happy ability to know where to find Raz when Raz has need of you. Getting information out of these Periite idiots is like squeezing milk from a stone. This is why Raz hates dealing with Daedric cults. Interesting question. Raz has learned that the Court of Bedlam has been attacking the cults of other princes, including those devoted to Meridia and Azura. Now, usually, if crazy cultists kill each other, it's good for Somerset. But this feels wrong. You do? Well, Raz trusts you. So I can tell you about an old friend who attends Meridia ceremonies in the Eton near Grotto. Raz doesn't approve, but it's her life, yes? This one will make contact and meet you outside Eton Nir. Raz was planning to head up north to Eton Nir after talking to these Periite imbeciles anyway, to check on his old friend. The Court of Bedlam's attacks on the other cults were particularly vicious, and this one worries so. War. That would explain the attacks. Raz isn't an expert on Daedric cults, but this doesn't sound like their usual behavior. This one thought they just sort of left each other alone. That's a terrible thing to say. No, Raz refuses to believe it. Raz's friend is a survivor. She's got to be all right. This one will go and make contact. Make sure she's fine. Then we'll meet you outside Eton Nir. Raz hears things. He heard about the attacks on the rival cults. He heard that the court consists of followers of three different princes. And he heard that even though the High Elves constitute the majority of the court's members, there is one Dark Elf. A single Dark Elf among a group of High Elves? Seems significant to Raz. Besides, everyone seems to fear her, but this one could not dig up any details. We should keep an eye out for this Dark Elf, yes?
I told Philbert.
In the water.
Why would you do that?
Because it wasn't helping.
You there. Do something You're a welcome sight, my friend. I could use some help to free these people. A dark entity called Katora set a trap for a group of adventurers. It locked them in their own minds. You're a welcome sight, my friend.